By the American Bar Association, as you can tell. Charles Dickens said of lawyers, they feed human misery for it feeds them, and I'm not one to disagree with him. I was slightly more lengthy in my denigration of them. I hope we don't have too many lawyers here in the audience.
Oh,
all right, okay.
It's only barristers.
This is a song called You Got a Bad Reputation. It's based on the film Mona Lisa, for which Bob Hoskins should have won the Academy Award. Out of my mind. We had a record out about 8 years ago. No, actually it was 9 years ago. That's good news. I mean, a lot of people had a record out 9 years ago. We made it under the name of Wild Cherry. No, that's not true. That's not what the this one was about the passage of time, and I very cleverly called it Time Passages. original band leader, Peter White.
Thank you. that cannot want. It is just 10 minutes, nothing more. Time to open the essentials. Yeah, come on, come on. False name inside the passport. Gold mine should come. Once again, get tomorrow to pass. Blow your minds, fill your hands, be your hearts. And put on for each time you wish a little more. You could ask, what do you want from me? What do you need to do? Don't rest for the wrong back. Why can't you ever do? It's a love, just a child. From a sweeping motor to the outcrops of a thousand years of gray. And the customs on the opposite takes you to one side and out of sight. You should be on your feet. You should hide up with the crowd. Once again, it's all over time. Once again, you're falling out of sight. And once it's gone, oh, it's evolved to a show to the night. What do you want from me? What do you need from me? No rest for the running man. Why can't you run me?
Of the prophecies of Nostradamus, which is what the song is called.
Thank you. changes.
Thank you.
Sherry.
I get two of them. Yeah, there's also
words. Okay, now wait. Probably a lot of you don't know how to make these things, but by the end of the evening, we'll have about 30 of them. I'm going to put them behind the speaker and let them get on with it. I don't think you want to watch. You know. When you're writing songs, some of them come out commercial. MTV to try and work out what it is that I'm supposed to do. I've come across something called heavy metal, and we play as loud as we can, but I've advanced all the way through the various forms of pewter to aluminium foil. That's aluminium foil. That's how far I've got. I'm not really heavy metal yet. I'm not even light metal. But this is as loud as we can play, and this is called Princess Olivia, and it may be something you can dance to if you want to. And it goes like this.
She says, I feel like I'm lost. It's like a rubber runner too.
We're in Florida. We're sitting down at the table, and we did five shows in 48 hours. It was the most we'd ever worked. We've been traveling in between all the time, so we haven't really had much sleep. And we were falling asleep at the table in between two shows in Orlando, Florida. And our guitar player suddenly produced this amazing trick, which I never knew he could do. He gave us an instrumental version of Somewhere Over the Rainbow, which knocks off Judy Garland's version by about 1%. We thought he might care to hear it tonight. He does it without the use of any instrument, just the boy who God gave to him and the rest of the women in the world. And, Steve Brecker will now perform Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Anyone over the age of probably about three knows the chorus. If you don't know the chorus, just look at the person next to you. They probably will. When I left school, I worked in the bedding department of a department store in Bournemouth, which is a town in the south of England. I worked there for 5 months, and then decided at the age of 17 this was a very silly way to lead my life and became a folk singer. And all these years later, I'm here. But while I was working in the bedding department, a song came out which I used to sing religiously all the time to myself, and it was quite long. It had lots of words, and it was probably from this that I developed an interest in words, or at least from this writer. And he's Bobby the Z from Hibbing, Minnesota, and you may know him as Bob Dylan. This song has a chorus that you really can get into and join in with, and I hope you'll join me on it, because it's just a great song to sing beneath the moon in Cleveland in the open air. Why not?
Yeah. Yeah.